Hello, welcome to the first in our series of video demos that we're going to be doing as we develop the FireEyes plugin, or what was previously known as the WorldSpace Developer Workbench. Today what I'm going to be focusing on is showing you a little bit of our script recording functionality, and I'm going to be showing that to you using the Facebook website, which I believe is one of the more complex websites that's out there in terms of its interactivity. Almost nothing gets generated on Facebook that is the result of a full page refresh, other than when you first go to the page and log in. Everything is generated using JavaScript. In fact, if you go in and you investigate all of the elements that are being shown, you'll actually notice that a lot of these elements, their IDs that are being generated on the fly. So the IDs, when you go in the second time and look at the same content, are not the same as they were the first time you went in and looked at their content. So a very difficult site to actually script and replay. And so one of the coolest features that we have is the ability to record a script that exercises some functionality. While you're exercising that functionality, we're analyzing it for accessibility, but then you can actually take that recorded script and replay it again to make sure that your accessibility has not been broken. You can also email that script to somebody else, a developer, for example, if you're working in QA and the developer wants to know how to reproduce an accessibility issue, you can email them or send that that script to them. They can replay the script and reproduce the exact same set of issues that you were able to reproduce. And so there's a lot of good ways that the script recording and replay functionality can be used during the development cycle to make a developer's job a lot easier in terms of being able to create functionality that's accessible. Also, if you're debugging functionality and you don't want to have to replay all the events over and over manually, you can just record that script, replay them, and so every time you're testing the changes that you've made to make sure that they are accessible, the functionality is working the way you want it to, you can just replay that script again. So that's kind of what it's going to be used for. So what I'm doing, I'm in FireEyes here. Here are my tabs. Here is my toolbar. I'm in the report tab right now. I'm going to hit reset. And what that's going to do is it's just going to clear everything that I've recorded up until now and start over. So we're starting on the my Facebook page over here. What I'm going to go do is I'm going to go and I'm going to make a Facebook post. Now, anybody who knows anything about the way Facebook is implemented will say, well, that's quite a difficult thing to record and replay. But I'm going to do it. So I'm going to say, here I am demoing the FireEyes script recording and playback. So what FireEyes is actually doing is recording every single keystroke, every mouse over, every single event that I've told it to record. And it's going to be able to replay all those back again. So here we have the text that I've typed. Okay, it's not particularly good text. I'm going to go in and change that, and I'm going to share that with people. So now what that's going to do is post that to my wall, and people can view that. But, I made a mistake. I didn't really want to post that. So let me go and see if I can delete that. Now, deleting that is done by going to your profile, and where you can see all the things that you've recently posted. I'm going to go to my profile, and here you see my profile. You see all the things that have been posted for me. And now I'm going to come in, and when you mouse over this element, go in and mousing over it, that's when it actually displays. So I'm going to mouse out again. I'm going to mouse back in, and that's when it displays this remove button. Okay, so now clicking that remove button, it brings up a JavaScript dialog box. So what that's doing, for anybody who knows anything about how these things happen, is actually dynamically adding that dialog box to the content. I'm going to go into that dialog box and press the delete button, and it's going to delete my post. Okay, all very well and good. My post is gone. No harm, no foul. So now let's see how FireEyes can replay those events exactly as we recorded them. So I'm going to go into the script. I think I can turn the script recording off. It doesn't really do anything because when it's replaying, it's not recording the events anyway. It turns that off so that the events don't get re-recorded. But it just makes it a little bit quicker when I come back again so that it doesn't start recording everything that I do. Click the play button. So now what FireEyes is doing is first it's going to the start page, which was my home page on Facebook. It's reloading that. And once that's reloaded, it'll start to replay all the other events, all the mouse over events that we did. So here you see it replaying all my mouse over events as I moused around the page, moused over my picture. Eventually it's going to get to the point where I clicked on that input box. There's the click on input box. Now it's going to redo all my typing. Now what FireEyes is actually doing here is it's remembering the timings, so that if your website in the back end actually takes time to do the things it has to do, then it remembers that time. And so when you replay that, if the server on the back end needs time to respond to that, it'll have picked up on those timings and it'll reuse them. And that what that allows us to do is it allows us to get a sense of the magnitude of the pauses between the replay events, and we can turn those up or turn those down, make them faster or slower to suit the way that the way that the server is responding. But that's pretty cool. So now we've got my posting has been replayed. Now you may have noticed that it didn't actually insert that extra space that I put in there. The reason for that is I wasn't telling it to pick up on mouse down and mouse up events. I only told it to pick up on them on certain types of events, so it didn't actually record that event. But I should be able to get that event recorded if I have my settings set up correctly. So now it's posted that to my page. It's now going to go to my profile, and it's going to go and mouse over my profile page. And that button should appear at the appropriate point in time. There it is, it clicks the button, and now the delete appears, and it's going to click the delete button. And voila, when it does that, my post is gone. So that's a relatively complex set of replay events that we've recorded and replayed with full fidelity. So now I'm exactly back where I was before I started this out. And that flexibility, that ability to script and replay complex JavaScript applications like Facebook is one of the key features of FireEyes that's going to allow developers and QA engineers to work together on testing applications for accessibility, fixing accessibility bugs, reproducing accessibility bugs, and then creating sets of regression suites that allow them to make sure that bugs don't reappear or code that was working correctly doesn't suddenly introduce bugs in the future. And in integration with the WorldSpace server, this gives you a very comprehensive set of functionality that allows you to do anything that you need to do in terms of testing for accessibility for rich internet applications.